can't tell, of course, up here, which way is up or which way is down, but we know from the writing on the wall. I think the first aspect is this complete sense of awe we see when looking at the Earth in space. It is this beautiful gem. It's kind of glowing blue, gracefully spinning. You can see the cloud pattern constantly evolving, the seasons, if you stay long enough, day and night cycles, the moon orbiting slowly around. And it is so obvious that it's the only place that's alive, that supports life around. And it makes me feel completely so lucky, so blessed we are to have this incredible home in the cosmos that can support life. See the thin layer of the atmosphere, and that is what keeps billions of species alive. It makes one feel kind of more responsible for Mother Earth. And also it's kind of a lesson of humility that none of this belongs to us, we belong to it. It's been adapting to the environment physically, you know. It's your body is not used to this strange feeling. It's fun, of course, to be weightless, but it takes a while to get your sleep pattern, your appetite, your sense of orientation, both in time and in space. That takes patience, and thankfully, that's why we always overlap expeditions. So whenever new people come on board, there's more experienced people who are there to kind of guide them. We got here, and we're guided by Alex Gerst and Serena Onion and Sergei Prokopyev. They showed us the ropes and then they left. Soon, actually in 2 days, two new crew members will come. Nick Haig, Christina Hammack, and Alexey Avchinin. And we will kind of be their guide. We will Alexey's experience, but the other two are rookies, so we will be their guide, showing them the ropes and helping them adapt. And once you got over the hump of feeling functional again, then we have the resources inside us. That's how humans are. We're wired to adapt and to evolve. Certainly do get homesick. I'm not going to try to hide that. You know, I miss my family, my friends, everything I love about life on Earth. But I know we'll go back there, so I try to enjoy everything that I have here. It's a very, very unique experience. It takes time to get adjusted. I'm now, after upwards of almost 3 months, completely adapted, as you can imagine, both physically and mentally, to the life up here, the culture up here. It is a different culture. It's a completely international culture, a very operational culture. Got to get used to, you know, flying. You got to learn how to fly. Initially, you bump everywhere. You got to learn how to not lose things, because things tend to fly away. You can just drop them down. And you got to learn how a station works. I mean, we do learn on the ground, but there's nothing like the reality of being up here. And we've been very busy and doing lots of amazing research. So we are blessed with a great expedition. You know, I think, like we say, the reason why we travel is so we can come back where we're at home and understand better where we're from. Part of exploration is that this ambition to understand our origins better. So being in space, yes, for me, certainly every morning when I open the cupola windows and I see our beautiful planet, I feel a sense of connection. I think crews who would be going on a very deep space mission would have a different experience. They would be probably more focused on the destination as opposed to the experience. And as we have evolved, we are broadening our perspective. Now we've reached a point as a species, our perspective is global, and therefore our challenges are global, and we will adapt and we will address them. I have no doubt the human spirit is really enduring, and we ultimately all want the same thing, a peaceful and healthy life on our beautiful planet. If I let my imagination run wild, I think space travel will be very common, just as common as taking the plane. It will never be easy, but that's the nature of technology. We get used to doing incredible things like driving cars, if you think about it, or using a cell phone, but they're part of our life thanks to technology. Now we have welcomed the commercial entities into space flight. I think that will help drive the prices down, and that will help kind of smooth out the technological aspects. And eventually, space will do two things for us. It will help us take better care of Earth, and it will help us in our quest to understand the universe better. And I think these are important aspects. And the third aspect, which we kind of get for free with this impulsion of exploration, look at all those flags behind me. Space exploration is by nature an international endeavor. And I think it really helps bring humans together with a single focus. Because up here, from up here, it's obvious that there are no boundaries. We're just humans on a single spaceship, Spaceship Earth.